Okay, my buddy old pal Artie's supposed to be cocooned in a corner with a nasty cold. But give him a hot celeb to interview, and he's strong as an ox. Typical. Well, I guess he was mystified with Mystica on Celeb Machine.
Totally down for her. Good afternoon and welcome to Celeb Machines right here on Odd Extreme. And I'm a bit uneasy about the person I'm going to interview today just because of her name. Does the name Mystica ring a bell? Well, get in and find out what she's like.
All night, it's so easy, it's all right.
Okay, so right here on Celeb Machines on Odd Extreme, I've got the one and only and the famous Mystica. How are you?
How are you? Fine.
Thanks for having us here. Huh?
Thank you, too. Actually, my first car here in the Philippines was Volkswagen.
That was a classic.
Yeah. I was excited because it was so rare to have that kind of car by the time, you know.
So you started out with a Volkswagen.
Volkswagen, but of course, when I went to Canada, Vancouver, and that's when I asked my husband to buy me a Jaguar, you know, yung SK.
Wow, okay. And you said...
67, you know, classic car.
It's a classic. And you said na dadalawa lang pala kayo na meron nun sa Vancouver. And who's the other guy who
had
fun?
I was John Travolta. And then, of course, when I had the chance to go to the States after 7 years in Canada, and that's when I decided to go to L.A., in order to have a stable job, so I had to apply as an exotic dancer. So that was the time that I was able to afford, like, Corvette. I had two Corvettes.
Wow, you had the best of all worlds. You had Jaguars, so they're English vehicles, and you had Corvettes too. American muscle, huh?
That's true. So the other one was 1997, and the other one was 1999.
Well, you know, what I've noticed is most people, especially Filipinos, when they're out there working abroad, that's when they get to realize their dreams. And in your case, you got Jaguars and Corvettes and all these nice cars. You know, what happened when were you able to take them back?
When I got back here in the Philippines, I was planning to buy a Mercedes. But then when I thought that, oh my God, it's not really worth having Mercedes here. It's just the way they drive here, you know, careless, you know, driving. And of course, like, and the road, you know, especially when I go out of town, you know. So instead of having a Mercedes, then I bought Honda Civic. So that's when I decided to, okay, I can drive, at least I can drive, you know, a little car. But of course, to be more practical, I decided to have, you know, Safari and Revel. Yeah, especially when I have my dancers as well. So I really needed bigger cars.
What are your dream cars, if ever?
I still would like to have my Corvette, you know. I'm very first.
Little red Corvette.
Real red and the silver. I'm still very frustrated because when I inquired here if I could be able to get those, they said you have to pay at least 200% tax. And I said, forget it.
Well, for a person, for a girl especially, who's been able to gone through those nice cars and now you're still hoping to get those nice cars again, what's your advice to all those women out there who are dreaming of getting those kinds of vehicles and eventually, you know, if they can't have it now, how do they have it in the future, etc.?
Well, first of all, as long as that's what you really like, you know, but that, don't ever force yourself if you can't really afford it.
This has been Artie with the one and only Mystica for Celeb Machines. I'll catch you back on Auto Extreme.
Get it?
It's alright.
Auto Extreme.